In this example, here it is given that the figure shows a conductor OA of length L placed along y-axis with one end at the origin. Here O is placed at origin. And in this region, a non-uniform magnetic field exists along Z direction, of which magnitude depends only on y-coordinate, which is given as B is B naught 1 plus y square by L square Tesla. We can see the magnetic field exists in Z direction here. And is saying if the conductor OA starts translating with velocity V naught I cap, we are required to find the induced EMF in this conductor. So here in solution, as the field is non-uniform, we need to consider an element in this conductor. Here we can consider if there is an element we consider at a height y, and this element is of width dy. And for this small element of width dy, if it is moving with the velocity v naught, a motional EMF will be induced in this element. Direction we can obtain by right hand palm rule, as it is going toward right, field is in upward direction. So positive charges will experience a force downward and negative upward. So upper end will be negative and lower end will be positive. So here we can directly write motional EMF induced in element dy is, here this motional EMF d can be written as b v naught and its length dy, because motional EMF v naught is given as bvl. Here b we can substitute as a function of y, which is b naught v naught multiplied by 1 plus y square by l square dy. This is now motional EMF induced, and for such a small EMF d, d, all these are in series. So we can write total EMF induced in conductor OA is, a total EMF across OA can be written as integration of DE. That's here B naught V naught is constant. This integration of 1 plus y square by L square dy, and will integrate in limits for the length of this conductor, which is from 0 to L. If we integrate it here, EOA is given as B naught V naught, and the integration will be integration of 1 will be y, and that y square is y cube by 3. So this y cube by 3 l square, and limits we put from 0 to l. So we substitute the values of limits in this integral value. This b naught v naught multiplied by l plus, this will be l cube by 3 L square, so that will be, this cube gets cancelled out, this will be L by 3. On simplifying, we are getting the value 4 by 3 B naught V naught L. That's the result of this problem.